matters to discuss. Not this one, nor this one, and this one less worthy still. Righting the balance. Beyond mortal realms, there doth exist an amalgamation of spirits akin to thine own, ensnared by the treacherous cult of the Absolute, felled in its name. They bear great discontentment with their destiny. For a mere pittance of coin, I might summon the worthiest among them to lend aid to thy undertaking. Most willingly, forsooth. Their passions doth run deep for what hath been wrought upon them. Suspicion always haunts the guilty mind. My services are all that I can proffer thee. What thou wilt do with them is for thee to undertake.
How can I help?
We all have our burdens, one way or the other.
Speak.
Yes?
Why do you insist on exhuming the past?
I was a slave. A vampire spawn. Kept by the Tsar family. Perhaps I still am.
I was never able to resist their commands.
But now, I've been conveniently lost. They won't ever control me again.
It's simple. Just find a vampire that will drink your blood and turn you into a vampire spawn. Their obedient puppet. In theory, the next step is to drink their blood. Once you've done that, you're free. And a true vampire. People think the biggest threat to a vampire is a cleric with a stake. It's not.
The biggest threat to a vampire is another vampire.
They're scheming, paranoid, power-hungry beasts.
So why would any vampire give up control over a spawn to create a competitor? Trust me, it doesn't happen. We can't. And yet I cross the threshold like moonlight through leaves. This worm is a powerful little beast, isn't it? Oh, don't be so glum. Look at the power it's bringing us. I can walk in sunlight, trespass upon any home, manipulate minds. There isn't another vampire in the realms like me. Granted, the looming doom is an issue, but why not enjoy the benefits while we can?
Something the matter?
tiring business, isn't it? All this traveling and adventuring. Why don't we take a little break, Allow ourselves a few moments of rest. Gives me a chance to talk to you about something. Well, rather important. We've been on the road together for a while now, haven't we? Survived some perils, overcame some obstacles. Ever since you were kind enough to free me from that stone, I've seen you demonstrate remarkable guile and courage. The way you defused the tension between Zevlor and Aradin. The way you stood in front of a crossbow to prevent a murder. In short, I've grown to trust you. The reason I make a point of saying this is that I've grown confident enough to tell you something I've yet to tell another living soul, except for my cat. You see, I have this condition, very different from the parasite we share, but just as deadly. The specifics are rather personal, but suffice it to say that it is a malady I've learned to live with, though not without some effort. What it comes down to is this. Every so often, I need to get my hands on a powerful magical item and absorb the weave inside. I can say no more on the matter. Not now, anyway. Just trust me when I say it's all of vital importance. It's been days since I last consumed an artifact, since before we were abducted. It's only a matter of time before my craving returns. That is why I turn to you. I need you to help me find magic items to consume. It is vital. Dare I say it? Critical. We've already done the finding. In fact, you have one in your possession. You know for yourself how hard won such an item was, and it will be no easier when even more are required to assuage my hunger. There'll be danger involved, or great cost. Splendid. Bit of boldness will serve us well. I'm sure we won't have to look very far to find what I need. Faerun overflows with magic-infused treasure. As do our packs, as a matter of fact. We've such an item already in our possession, primed for the moment the need arises. I hope I can count on you.
I was just thinking about you and that delicious moment we shared the other night. The very same. I've had this condition for 2 centuries, but truth be told, you were my first. In all these years, I've only ever fed on beasts. Drinking the blood of thinking creatures is a different thing entirely. You were delectable. And now I can't help but wonder how the others taste. Alas, it doesn't hurt to ponder the question, though. Take Gale, for example. He strikes me as someone whose blood is rich, refined, like well-aged brandy. But the Gith, what in the hells would she taste like? Well, that sounds very appealing. I'm almost convinced. Absolutely. A mere thought experiment. So, In the spirit of theoretical questions, if you had to take a bite from one of them, who would it be? A fine choice. She is enticing. Although, the more I think on it, the hungrier I get. I better go find something I can actually get my teeth into. There's nothing that tasty lurking out in the woods, but I'll make do. Sweet dreams.
Something's wrong. I feel... Ah, it hurts. Darkness, protect me. No, I'm fine. Forget it. I don't know. I'm fine. It's past whatever it was. And stop looking at me like that. I'm not sprouting tentacles just yet. To tell you something, I'll use my mouth. Understand? Fumble in my head again, and I'll gut you. I know that look. You're wondering why I was in pain before. Let's just clear the air about that now. It's just an old wound that hurts me from time to time. Nothing to be concerned about. It's nothing to do with the tadpoles, at least, in case your imagination is in danger of getting away from you. It's just something I have to live with. Quite a lot, if I'm being honest. But it always passes quickly, so I can manage. Positive. You can trust me on that. I don't know what you mean. It's nothing, really. Makes you think I'm hiding anything. If I've something to share, I'll let you know. You've already pestered me with your notions once today. If I have something to add, I'll tell you.
Thank you.
hope the goblins aren't smart enough to poison their blades.
Looking for steel? I have, well, something close.
Have you spoken to Korga? Of course, you have your own business to attend to. But if the druids won't abandon this ritual of theirs, it will be trouble for all of us.
No, sir. But if there's a clear path past those goblins, they'll find it.
Yes, of course.
Used to think the goblins would kill us the second we set foot outside. But after hearing what you did at the gate, well, I still think they'll kill us. But at least we can put up a fight. Optimism, and then there's stupid Hun. Plenty of us fell to monsters already. I don't see the rest of us lasting long out there. But if you're so sure we will, why not put a little gold on the line? Excellent! And since I ain't one to leave a debt unpaid, that means we're destined to meet in Baldur's Gate. Looking forward to it.
I already told you my stuff. Have it! Help!
Shadow. Such a grim lake. There's such a beautiful time.
Could you not stare so blatantly in my neck when you say that, please?
Oh, but do keep calling her flower. She'll love that.
You're a true soul. You can't die. Please, stay with us.
I don't think he's conscious. Can you hear us, Ed?
You, not a step closer.
A strange symbol glows, marked on their flesh, and something within you stares in response.
Your sword.
Wait.
The injured man locks eyes with you. A familiar squirming churns in your head. Your minds intertwine. You see his siblings, Andric and Brynna, new recruits. Yours to shepherd.
Protect them. He is a true soul.
Mind him. He will.
Edwin! Ed! Please!
He's with the Absolute now. You're a true soul. Edwin, our brother, he was chosen. Like you. Do you have orders for us? We were reporting to Edwin.
What? Are you testing us?
A true soul, like you, has been chosen by the Absolute. You speak with her voice. Your words are her command. She grants you the power to enforce her will. And when the time comes, the true souls, you, will rule. We know that all too well, sir, but the Absolute sent us here.
We're looking for fugitives, survivors from that ship that crashed farther west of here. You! Brynna, kill him!
The Absolute? Same as that goblin. Curious.
On the move.
To the chase.
Impero! Tequila!
strange power resonates within the corpse. It calls to you. Your limbs move of their own accord. There's something of value here, something your mind craves. Why let its host's memories go to waste? The tadpole has absorbed it all. Its experience could nourish you, strengthen you. Compulsion takes over. Your actions are no longer your own.
As soon as they need to. Vile parasites.
All the more reason to rid ourselves of our own uninvited guests.
Still breathing, despite everything.
These tieflings prove fragile. Never mind to end their misery myself.
Calm yourself. They're survivors, not soldiers.
I fail to see the distinction.
Did that cow just give me the side eye? Is that normal?
Daughter, go right now!
She's a thief, Hellspawn! And you will wait for Corga's judgment. Now get back!
Oh, let me through, Mragrishem, or I'll rip your damn throat out!
Give him a chance. You,
Get back! Keep back! Force my hand and I'll show you its claws.
A moment, Giona.
What? Oh, I understand. You! Apparently Korga wants to see you. Go ahead.
I do wish I could understand you.
Spill some blood.
You have good timing. Never been much of a fighter, so wrestling a bugbear would have gone poorly. But you're not here for heroics, are you? Avernus's stench is all over your skin. Let me guess. Your devil mistress sent you to get her soul coin back. Too bad. I earned it, fair and square. I'm going to be chased all over Faerun for this damn coin, aren't I? Fine. Take it as a grudging payment for the rescue. Now leave me in peace.
A soul coin, true to its name, holds a mortal soul inside. It serves in the Nine Hells as very valuable currency.
No one back home will ever believe this.
Sorry.
This is madness, Korga. She's just a...
A what, Wrath? A thief? A poison? A threat? I will imprison the devil. And I will cast out every stranger. Girl,
You mean parasite. She eats our food, drinks our water, then steals our most holy idol in thanks. Wrath, lock her up. She remains here until the rite is complete. And keep still, devil. Teela is restless.
Come, Korga. We took back the idol. Surely...
Do it. I hear the Tree Father's spirit in your words. It is as you say. Sivisif, Teela, to me! Out, thief. My grace has its limits.
It hurts.
Thank you, Korga. Master Halsin...
Halsin isn't here. Keep his name off your tongue, lest Teela pierce it.
Ridiculous. We just let her run off.
She's a child.
A devil child. One who tried to steal from us.
Yet she failed. That's what matters.
Go on. Say it. You think I'm a monster? Yes, you would say so. I know your kind. You see only villains and victims. A viper bears her fangs, defending her brood. I call her mother, you call her monster. No matter. I took back the idol of Sylvanas, and the rite is resumed. We will seal the grove, free from harm, free of intruders. The rite of thorns. It is the Tree Father's gift that none come to harm. When we speak the final prayer, the great vine will sprout forth. The grove will be cloaked in bramble and thorn. No one enters, no one leaves. Sanctuary. None of this can happen while Outlanders infect us. Sylvanas demands that we choke them out. And mine perish if he stays. You showed great mettle at the gate. The mettle of a skilled sword for hire. I want you to provide your services to Zevlor. Offer to guide the Outlanders out of the grove. I'm sure they'll reward you well. They're to be gone before final prayer. If they are not, the viper must strike. You will do more than speak. This tale ends but one way. With the Outlander rot cleansed, and the grove forever shrouded.
Temple of Shah? Where? And what's this about a curse?
The towers seized the battle done. The moonrise broke the darkest one. The broken helmet bears the mark of Shah, the Dark Lady. And if the darkest one is Shah, Moonrise must be her celestial sister.
I see you. Just give me a moment.
This Medicatrix.
There. It's up to her now. Life or death. Now, what was it you needed? I do what I can. For most folks, that's enough. Come here. Let's have a look at you. You seem healthy enough. A bit tired around the eyes, maybe. A tadpole. A mind flayer tadpole. I'll do what I can. Come, follow me. I might be able to help. We need to be quick. This way. This one had the same problem as you. Attacked us in the woods together with some goblins. Tadpole crawled out of his head soon after. I'll do the best I can. I'm no Master Halsenmind. He'd have your tadpole out like that. Still, we have options. You don't have to be here for this.
Please, don't mind me. I'll just watch.
All right. Let's see what we can do. Of course. Now, tell me what's been happening. Any symptoms? Strange events? Victims can identify each other. Not that the others know they're victims, of course. How'd you pick up the parasite? Halsen was desperate to find where all this was happening. A mind flayer ship? But Master Halsen was sure. Look. You've been straight with me, so I'll be straight with you. You're dangerous. If you transform here, we're all dead. But you seem like a good soul. You deserve a chance to save yourself. This is a vial of wyvern poison. Swear to me, you'll swallow it if you feel any symptoms. The thorn? Coated in a fatal toxin. It was a last resort, in case I couldn't trust you. I don't have a cure. Only a way out. I'm sorry for misleading you.
but I had to be sure you weren't a threat before I told you everything. Now, do I have your word or not? I hope it doesn't come to that, but thank you. Here. You know, I've spent my life treating folk and never once saw a mind flayer infection. Then suddenly, there's dozens of you. Maybe more. Master Halston and I were tracking them, studying them, trying to figure out what the hell was going on. Because you should all be changing. There should be a small army of mind flayers out there. But you're not. Weird powers aside, you seem perfectly normal. Mind flayers reproduce by infecting someone with their parasite. 7 gruesome days later, the victim transforms and a new mind flayer is born. The thing in your skull, though, it's different to anything in our records. It's one of their worms for sure. But this one gives you powers, telepathic connections, and it doesn't turn you into one of them. Not yet, anyhow. Could be, but there's a lot we don't know. Infected, folks like you, have been converging on an old temple of Saluna, and I've no idea why. When Master Halston heard the adventurers were heading that way, he saw a chance to get answers, joined on the spot. Whatever he found there, he didn't make it back. The thing is, I've sent birds to find him, but the place is rotten with goblins. None of us can even get close. You, though, you're one of them. Technically speaking, I mean. They won't kill someone carrying their parasite. If you can find Halston and get him out of there, we can discover what he learned. And perhaps he can save your life. How's that sound? Thank you. It would mean everything to the Grove. To me. I wish I could tell you more. But only those adventurers know what happened out there. All I can say for sure is they all went to the old temple of Saluna. And Master Halston didn't make it back. Good luck out there. And if things start to go bad, remember the vial. Remember your oath.
One step at a time, Nettie. Come on.
Why, Vampire? Never tried it, and I hope to keep it that way.
Better a quick drop.
Something over there.
Manus, I just want my bed.
Keep your hands to yourself. You're being watched.
Trust no one. symbol.
Let's move.
Thank you. everywhere. Someone wasn't as fortunate in their choice of campsite as us.
Too tight. I need a shovel. These boots have seen everything. Time for some bloody work.
bear.
What should I do?
Time for a cull.
Fury, I am death. Let my name be known.
To let up.
Ha ha! fury. I am death. Taste my fury.
Position.
Too much to bear.
Battle has taken its toll. I should rest.
Never a dull moment.
Thank you.
Time to see what new horror's waiting for us.
Stay idle.
Thank you.
focused.
Survival is all that matters.
Focused.
Incredible!
way. My faith will protect me.
Thank you.
must be on my way.
Death.
Time to strike. Taking position. Swift and lethal. Ah!
take you.
Victory awaits. Healing. Move. A little help, please. Time to waste.
Ugh.